Hey guys, I've been getting a lot of requests that I should make tutorial on how I make my animations. So this video is all about that, how I make everything from voice to animation, how I do everything and what software I use. Hopefully this will be helpful, and if you want to make your animations, maybe this will help you, who knows, you know? Yeah. Always start with the audio. If you're not gonna do that, you're gonna have a bad time, trust me. I know this from experience. Because otherwise you'll have to move the animation on the way. But if you have audio, you basically make animation around it and it saves you a bunch of time. So here I have a little piece. It's about Poland crying about space. Yeah, but let's just hear it.
I want into space.
Next, you save that shit, and yeah, that's it. And then you use this program called Levelator, which basically evens out your the volume of your audio, so it's not quiet or very loud at some points. Yeah, so next you're gonna have to draw some background. I use this program called Clip Studio Paint. Clip Studio Paint, yeah, I use this program and it's pretty good. I like it more than Photoshop. I think for drawing cartoons is a lot better, but that's just my opinion. You can use any program to draw backgrounds because the program I used to animate with, it's really not possible to draw anything else than just, you know, animating stuff. So anything that's not gonna be moving or static, draw in this program or Photoshop or any other program, because it's gonna be pain in the ass in the animation software. And it's coming just in a bit. Yeah, all I'm doing here is just basically drawing on top of my sketch, drawing grass, clouds, some bushes, you know. For animating software I use Animate Studio or Moho, or I don't know how you call it. Anyways, I have a love and hate relationship with the software. It does some things really well and some things really bad, and I'm gonna explain as we go. I'm just gonna do a little demonstration. So here I have a Countryball rig. I'm just moving it, playing with it, showing you how it works. But you can make any rig you want, and you can just assign actions to it or make do certain things. And even if doing the animation, if the rig doesn't have predefined action, you can just make up as you go. So it's really good. As you can see, I can do really fast and animate quickly. But there's a problem with the software, and before you even decide to buy this or use the software, if you enjoy drawing, just don't use it. Just use Animate CC or Flash or whatever. Just don't use the software, because you're not gonna, you know, draw as much. And yeah, but if you don't mind drawing less or you wanna save time, then you should consider it, but only consider it. Download the trial, play with it, because it has kind of a steep learning curve, and it took me about 1 month till I fully started kind of understand this program and start using its full potential. But yeah, it takes some time, and but when you learn it, it's pretty good. And like I said, it does some stuff good and some stuff bad. Now I'm gonna show some bad stuff. For example, if I start drawing, like you see here, I use pencil tool or whatever, and when I draw, it merges my vectors and it's not as accurate. It's really pain in the ass to draw with this software. So that's why I said anything static or that's not gonna be animated, do it outside of the software. Trust me, you'll just save some time. But when you need to animate some stuff, it's pretty easy. It's just harder to draw it. But once you draw on it, you can animate just by moving, as you can see, vectors or points, and it animates automatically. So it saves you a lot of time, but it's a steep learning curve. Yeah. So yeah, that's it. And I'm gonna start animating now. It was just a little showcase of the software, if you haven't heard of it. And if you did, and if you're interested, I would just, you know, suggest go look for some tutorials or something. I'm just gonna do a rough introduction on what I'm using. So next, I put everything into scene. I put two country balls, change their flags. I already have flags predefined because I made a lot of animations before, and once I create one, I just save it in the rig, and when I need to use it again, I can reuse it. I change the eye expressions. I already have them predefined, or I can make new one easily if I need to. And I start animating mouth, what they're saying. And also I have mouth action predefined as well, so all I'm doing is just listening to what he's saying and setting the mouth the correct positions, and it will animate it automatically. And once this done, I start adding movement and changing the camera movement to fit everything in a scene. So it looks pretty easy, but these rigs had a lot of work before. But basically, when you set up your rig, and if the flow stays consistent and not a lot of stuff changes in the animation, you can animate pretty quickly with the software. So that's a huge plus to this software, because if you don't have changing rigs or changing a lot of changing stuff in your animation, it's consistent. This software is really good. It took me about 15 minutes to finish this animation. All I do next is just put some music on top of the on top of animation. That's the last step, and yeah, here's the final result.
I want into space.
And that's it. Hopefully this has been helpful to you in some way. I wanted to do rough in an introduction on what I use, because if I would go into more detail, this video would take a lot of time, and if you're interested, you can investigate on your own. And yeah, see you next time.